What's the potential of opening up a laundromat business? Is it worth it? Is there an underlying potential waiting to be tapped into? Let's find out everything about that in today's episode. Jeff Orgill started Rosie Wash Express Laundry as a way to earn passive income so he could spend more time with his family. He bought a fully operational laundromat back in 2017 near his home, and the business has been growing ever since. Now, it didn't happen by itself. He made some improvements which contributed to his success. What are the advantages of purchasing an established laundromat versus starting one from scratch? Gosh, if you think of any other better returns, you guys, comment below. We'd like to take a look at them. Today, we'll learn Jeff's secret to success. He'll tell us how he was able to double his pickup service in the last 3 months, how much he invested to buy the laundromat, and what he's doing marketing-wise to build his customer base. What was your revenue the first year when you got started as opposed to today?
A great idea we got from our repair technician was to do a rewards card.
What are the monthly expenses for your laundromat? We want to break that down into numbers and where it goes. We'll also find out what life is like for a laundromat owner and whether it turned out to be as passive as Jeff was hoping for. So make sure you like this video, subscribe to our channel, and let's go meet Jeff and pick his brain to understand the secrets to his success in the laundromat world. Jeff, tell us a little bit about yourself. What's your background and what led you to purchasing a laundromat business and getting into this industry?
My background is as a filmmaker, editor, writer, director, producer. I like technology, I like machines, I like automation. I transitioned over to getting a laundromat when I think I got a newsletter in an email about passive income.
Interesting.
And
okay.
It just sparked my interest, and I was tired of sitting at a desk editing all the time. And so I started looking in laundromats, and I'd probably been like researching it for a year or two. And then we found this one, which is close to where we live. We live about 10 minutes away.
Mm-hmm.
And
close to home, that's nice.
Found out that we could buy the property, the building, and that was a big stumbling point with the laundromat is a lot of them are leased, so you have to pay a lease on the building.
Gotcha.
And that's a pain in the butt because it keeps going up and up and up, and they kind of force you to raise your prices and time it out a certain way.
Jeff, when you acquired this laundromat, what was the initial cost? And then on top of that, you made some investments, you probably made some improvements. In total, what was that number like?
Let's see. Well, we bought the property, we bought the building, we bought the business. I think that was $700,000.
Okay.
And then we got retooled it, so we got new equipment in here. The washers and dryers are new.
All of it?
Not. There's a couple that were still in good condition that we kept, like maybe 20%, 25% of it. The other stuff, we got new stuff. It was kind of a disaster as far as like the staff was in there tinkering with stuff to get it to restart. It looked bad, you know. So when you get new equipment, you reduce all your costs, your bills, your utilities. It's more efficient.
Right.
So that alone paid for the loan on that stuff.
Okay. So as far as improvements, what dollar amount was that after property and improvement acquisitions?
Probably pushing $300,000 now.
So you were all in almost close to $1 million.
Yeah.
What does this machine cost?
This machine is about a $5,000 machine from one of these. We have 9 of those.
And then what about these? These are probably on the low end?
These are about $1,000 a piece, maybe $1,100. I think on sale they were like $1,000 or $900. Yeah.
And I see you've got the bigger ones. What about those, including the dryers behind them?
Well, these are 30 pound. These are 40 pound.
Okay.
And those are 60 pounds over there. And those are 80 pounds, so it's kind of zigzagging. But these are our most popular machines right here. These are killing it. I'm actually thinking of getting maybe 2 more over there in that corner to replace those old ones.
What are they running you, the bigger machines, dollar-wise?
To buy, or how much are they earning?
How much do they cost?
Those ones, I think, are $6,500 a piece.
Okay.
And those ones are $8,000, and then those are $10,000.
Wow.
So all these
machines.
Yeah, all these machines, the new equipment was about $150,000 for these new machines. And then the dryers And these two machines and the heating system was another 100,000, I believe.
What was your revenue the first year when you got started as opposed to today?
I think it was about 220,000.
First year?
For the first year, yeah.
Where are you at today?
I should say it was 220,000 when we bought it. Mm-hmm. And where we're at today is, last tax return, I think it was 270,000.
Okay.
And I think by the end of the year, we'll be past 300,000.
So that's a pretty good return on investment, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, it's about, just based I think on, it's 36%.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, gosh, if you think of any other better returns, you guys, comment below. We'd like to take a look at them. Jeff, with the laundromat business, is it a seasonal business? And what's a good day, dollar-wise, for the laundromat? What's a bad day, if we could put it that way, for the laundromat?
Our strong day is going to be Saturday or Sunday, usually Sunday.
What's the revenue for those days?
On a good Sunday, just from the machines alone, will be about $800.
$800, okay. And you've got other revenue? Bring that in as well, in total.
So the other sources of revenue would be, there's the vending, there's a pure water machine, there's a couple of vending machines, soda machine, snack machine, massage chair, ATM, all these little trickles of income.
Okay.
That brings in another maybe $1,500 a month.
Wow.
Between all those ancillaries.
On a monthly basis. Okay.
And then there's the big thing that's growing for us right now, though, would be the wash and fold, drop-off laundry.
Right, okay, so the pickup.
So that's a whole different part of the business that mm-hmm. we sort of just opened in the last year, and it's really taken off in the last maybe 2 or 3 months. And so we're just watching that curve right now and pretty excited about that.
Yeah, let's talk about numbers real briefly. What are the monthly expenses for your laundromat? We want to break that down into numbers and where it goes. Mm-hmm. And then also, what's your biggest overhead?
Okay, our biggest overhead at a laundromat is usually going to be, well, now it's probably staff, employees.
Okay. How many do you have?
We have 4 employees. They're all part-time. So our biggest expense, single expense, would be employees. And then there's your utilities, all right. The water, gallons and gallons. You know, we go through, I think it's like 200,000 plus.
I was going to say a couple thousand gallons, but you're talking
gallons
hundreds
of water.
Of thousands
of gallons. The LADWP bill is about $3,500 a month. Which is actually not bad. There's some laundromats who have like $10,000. This is a small to medium-sized laundromat.
Gotcha.
But there are mega mats that have, you know, 3 times as many machines.
Mm-hmm. So you've got utilities, we've got employees.
We have a technician, a repair guy that comes every week. We have a...
what does that run you on average?
He's $350, like a retainer.
Okay.
We have an accountant. What else we have? There's the gas, which the dryers use the gas, the water heater. We just got a tankless water heating system. I think it's great. That's something laundromat people are, it's a controversial thing. Big boiler tank that holds your water, or a flash heater that there's 3 in a row, and it's on demand. As soon as the machine starts, it kicks in and heats up the water as needed.
Did you start to see savings with that?
Yeah. When we bought the laundromat, the utilities were creeping up on $6,000 a month.
Wow.
And now they're down to about $4,500.
Jeff, let's talk about different profit margins in the laundromat business. So you have people that are coming in, wash their clothes here. You're mm-hmm. also going out, cleaning, delivering back and forth. How do they differ between each other?
The industry average for a laundromat is supposed to be about a 25% profit margin. And since we've started offering drop-off service and now pickup and delivery service, the margin's gone up to 36%, and I think it's going to continue to go higher.
That's a really good number.
Yeah, and the reason for that is that people who do pickup and delivery, they just give you all their laundry. So you get a lot more laundry, mm-hmm. but you're not really using more machines. You're not using more water necessarily. You're using your laundromat more efficiently. You're using the staff you already have on hand. So all your costs stay the same. So a lot of that is just extra on top.
Gotcha.
So that's why the profit margin's getting increased by that.
What advice would you give our audience who are running a laundromat business to increase their profits? What have you been doing that you can share with us to make that happen?
A great idea we got from our repair technician was to do a rewards card. So
rewards
when they
card.
Do 10 okay. washes, they get stamps. For every time they come in and they do their laundry, they get a stamp. And after the 10th one, they can turn in the card and they get like a free wash. Plus we enter them in a raffle. We do the raffle every quarter, whatever. We put it on as a Facebook Live. We give away TV sets, kids' bikes, mm-hmm. stuff like that. So it kind of creates like a marketing opportunity. It's constantly interfacing with the customers, and they always come up and want that stamp. And it's just goodwill, you know.
They appreciate it. Who doesn't want to win something?
Yeah, exactly.
So this is an interesting question, because I know you were looking for a business that would ultimately give you passive income. Mm-hmm. How passive is it at this point? How many hours a week are you spending currently in the business, and how do you hope that will change soon?
It's not very passive. That was a big surprise initially. I think of it as a fun toy. Like, I like to tinker with it. Like, I'm into the, we just got new software, we got a new website, so I'm spend a lot of time at home playing on the computer, messing around with that stuff. Okay. There's the marketing aspect right now. I'm doing all the marketing myself. But on the flip side, it has to become completely passive by 2023. Part of the reason we got a laundromat is we're planning to do a year-long sabbatical, possibly longer than a year. We're going to take our sailboat and go down to the Sea of Cortez. And so in order to do that, it's got to be truly passive. All the systems have to be in place. Part of that process is going to be automating it so that it's a completely cashless store. One of my biggest jobs right now is counting the money.
That would be great.
It's largely a cash-based business.
How many hours a week are you here then?
I'm actually in the store 4 hours a week.
Four hours a week or day?
4 hours a week.
Wow, okay.
But I do go out and get like products to stock the inventory. Mm-hmm. That takes a couple hours. I do the pickup and deliveries now. So we have about 13 regular pickup and deliveries. That takes maybe a few hours a week. So altogether, I'm probably spending 10 to 20 hours a week.
Jeff, what are the advantages of purchasing an established laundromat versus starting one from scratch?
That's a great question. So the city, especially Los Angeles, charges when you put in things that are going to impact the sewage system. So every machine you want to put into a new laundromat, they're gonna ding you for that. So there's a huge startup cost. This is already grandfathered in. So all the sewage is taken care of for the laundromat. So that's a huge
savings. You know,
and there's the permitting and all the hoops you'd have to jump through with building that. So that's one of the big advantages. You've already got your customer base built in. People know you're here. Mm-hmm. So as far as marketing stuff, you're already hitting the ground running. People are already using the laundromat. So
yeah,
those are two big things.
Yeah. This is the end of part one. I hope you guys really enjoyed it and got inspired for those who want to get into the laundromat business. If you haven't liked this video already, take a second, just a second, like this video right now, subscribe to our channel, and make sure you check out part two. The link is in the description below or the thumbnail.